First of all, I want to thank you for attending this webinar. Motivated seller listing leads from public records. There are millions of leads and there are fresh new leads every single day. My name is Eddie Zubia. I started this journey in real estate 30 years ago. Everything that I will be sharing with you is a result of me doing it, being in the trenches of real estate success. I have been adjusting, modifying, tweaking real estate marketing campaigns to make them profitable. Real estate listings are profitable. Working with listings is a lot more profitable and a lot more fun than working with buyers, right? When you get a good sellable listing from a motivated seller, you will be paid a commission. Listing generation system will show you how to get as many listings as you want, how to get listings from motivated sellers that will practically beg you to take their 6% listings. A real estate listing, you can double end the listing and get paid the whole 6% commission. Or a buyer can bring you, a buyer's agent can bring you a buyer and you share the commission with a buyer's agent. Either way, you are gonna get paid. Everyone in real estate does the same thing that everyone else does. They work with buyers. In tight inventory markets, it's very tough. It takes months and months to find a property, to get them qualified, to get the offer accepted. I heard the horror stories of working with buyers. Or agents work with FSBOs or expired listings or farm a geographical area. FSBOs get approached by a lot of agents. And there are services that sell the same leads to a lot of agents. Expired listings. A friend of mine recently had a listing expire and he did not renew it. He received 19 calls in a matter of a few hours. All the agents were promising the moon and the stars and were lowering their commissions. They are positioning themselves as a commodity and stepping on each other's toes. Farming a geographical area, you are a commodity. It takes months and months of work and a lot of money to get things going. In listing generation system, you will be closing escrows in between 60 to 90 days, and I will show you how to position yourself to be the only logical choice for your real estate seller and his needs. I know most of you have been scammed and burned buying leads, buying coaching, buying real estate scripts. I am not going to sell you leads. I am going to show you a new way of thinking. I was on the phone with a client and she was telling me that she just spent $250 for 10 listing leads, probably the same leads that they're going to sell to 10 other agents. I am going to show you how to generate your own leads. I am going to show you how very successful, rich real estate investors think, how they look at the real estate market, how they strategize their real estate businesses. It is my goal to give you some fresh, innovative ideas on how to operate your real estate business and your career and take it to and advance it to the next level. I am going to share with you how I started my real estate career as a listing agent when everyone was telling me that I had to be a buyer's agent first. My real estate success story. My older brother went to UCLA and my older sister went to USC, but college was not for me. My brother-in-law is a general contractor, and between my brother-in-law, my sister, and my dad, they decided I should go to electrical contractor school to work with my brother-in-law, that we would help each other to get jobs. I started going to electrical contractor school, and I would go to school from 7 a.m. to 11 a.m., and I got a part-time job working at a real estate records company. The real estate records company, Real Estate Success. It was the most basic job that someone could get in real estate. I would research real estate records, ownership records, chains of title, liens on properties, and so forth. At the real estate records company, every morning at 4 a.m., somebody from our office would go to the county register recorder's office and retrieve the foreclosure notices and the notices of trustee sales. The person would bring the data back to the office and we would process it. We would verify the names, the owners, the address, the loans, and all the information we would get for free from the county recorder's office. We would put it on a format that was easy to read, and we would send out the information to our clients. The clients were attorneys, lenders, real estate investors, real estate agents. The owner of the company had 500 clients that would pay between $300 to $500 per month. The owner would place small classified ads in newspapers, newsletters, real estate magazines, legal newspapers to get clients. The county register recorders. There's one in every county. At the county recorder's office, there are thousands of documents that are recorded every single day. All of the real estate records are recorded there. Birth certificates, marriage certificates, IRS liens, state tax liens, child support liens, abstract of judgments, and the list goes on and on. All of the information that is recorded at the county records is available to anyone, and it's free. Occasionally, a client would ask for special searches and miscellaneous searches, and we would do it for them. The clients were sophisticated real estate business people. I would talk to them, real estate investors, attorneys, agents. It was really cool, the conversations I would have with them. I have been in real estate ever since and never looked back. If a guy like me can have success in real estate, so can you. I'm a regular guy with no special talents. I learned so many things by talking to guys and working with them. My second job in real estate, I worked with a real estate lender. I was doing my work, and one of the clients would always have special requests and special searches. I would just do whatever he asked for. One day, he offered me a job. There were three partners that owned the lending company. They would buy the foreclosure leads and from the public records company that I worked for. Every day, we would receive the notices of foreclosures and the notices of trustee sales, and we would send them a direct response flyer or letter offering them a loan. And we would find investors for the loans that they would write up from the county recorder's office. Those guys made so much money. They would sometimes fund their own loans. They would buy loans at discounts from other investors that would need cash. Bankruptcy attorney. My third job, I got offered a job working for a real estate bankruptcy attorney. The attorney would buy the list of notices of default and the notices of foreclosures and the trustee sales. And the trustee sales are the properties that are going to be sold at public auction at the steps of the courthouse in about 30 days after the notice is recorded. I am just giving you broad information here. Every day, we would receive the list of notices of default, foreclosures, and the notices of trustee sale, and we would send them a direct response letter or flyer. The attorney would offer his services. The attorney was filing between 40 to 50 cases a month. He was making a lot of money. At the peak of the recession, the attorney was doing 40 to 50 cases a month. As the economy was recovering, there was less and less foreclosures and less notices of trustee sale. I was an office manager, and the attorney wanted to do more cases. He wanted to do the 40 to 50 cases a month. The economy did not lend itself for it anymore. The economy was recovering. Simply put, the numbers were not there. The attorney adjusted his marketing, and we went back to the public records and arranged to get the notices of foreclosure, the notices of default, the IRS liens, the state tax liens, the child support liens, abstracts of judgments, and the wage garnishments. So IRS liens means that they owed money to the IRS. State liens means that they owed money to the state. Child support means that they owed child support money either to the county or to the mother or the father. And it just depended. It could be somebody could have an IRS lien for $5,000 or $250,000. It just depends. There was always people in trouble with all of these things and all the leads we got from public records. And the notices of default, we would send them multiple flyers. We would send them two or three flyers or letters before the notice of trustee sale was going to get recorded. And I also implemented a referral program. All of the past clients would get holiday cards from us, And we would throw in a few business cards and ask for referrals. The attorney again got slammed with cases. He was getting car accidents, slip and falls, cases, divorces, contract work, and all of these he would refer to other attorneys for a referral fee. So far, I have showed you three companies that make a lot of money from getting records from public records: a real estate records company, a real estate lender, and a real estate bankruptcy attorney. Let's continue. How I got started with real estate listings. I was working with real estate investors, and we were buying and selling discounted mortgages and properties across the country. We were in the process of wrapping up loose ends on their investment files because they had just made so much money that they were retiring. I was at the crossroads of my career. How do I start my own thing in real estate, or do I get another job? Working with someone in real estate, they would pay me between $3,000 to $4,000 per month. Starting my own business in real estate, I could earn as much money as I wanted, and I will be paid what I am worth. I had already been working in real estate for other people, and they had made so much money. I understood real estate as a business. I had seen a lot of people make a lot of money in real estate, and I was thinking, why not me? If they can do it, I can do it. Why is it that 87% of people that get into real estate do not make it? They quit after 2 to 5 years. That's according to the National Association of Realtors. I do not know the answer to that. What I can tell you with certainty is how I have real estate success. I have real estate success because I was taught. I worked for real estate masters for 13 years. They would have meetings, and I would sit in on their meetings, and they would give me daily tasks to do for them. I learned so many things working for them. I was working with my boss, and we were wrapping up loose ends on their investment files. He was an older guy in his 60s, and he had been in real estate his whole life, his whole career. And in conversation, I told him I was thinking of getting into real estate sales. In a serious tone, he told me, if you're going to get into real estate sales, okay, you will do fine. But only work with real estate listings. Work with listings only. At the time, I did not understand. I wanted to work with everyone in real estate. I wanted to work with loans because I already had experience with loans. I wanted to work with buyers because a big brokerage house that I interviewed at told me that I would have success working with first-time home buyers. And their logic was, if I messed something up, the client would not know any better. I wanted to work with leases, businesses. I wanted to work with everything. That conversation saved my real estate career, and it saved me a lot of costly mistakes because I focused, because I listened when my boss mentor advised me to focus on real estate listings only. I started a real estate listing marketing campaign, getting all the records for free. I would go to the courthouse and retrieve the records myself. I wrote and created my own listing flyers, letters, and postcards. And in a few short months, I was closing an average of 3 real estate listings a month, working by myself. As I started to close escrows, I had the money to hire assistants to retrieve the leads. And I did not buy them from a service. That is how I was taught from my mentors to retrieve the data from public records ourselves. Whenever we would buy lists or leads, the leads were never any good. It was always a lot of wasted money, time, and energy. But when we retrieved our own data, it was gold. And we would go to the public record. When you go to the public records yourself, the ideas will start flowing. You will see things that other agents do not see. There are several sources of real estate listings with simply no competition. They are right in your own backyard. They are going to be obvious to you once I show you. The plan is to build a fortress in your real estate listing business. I show you how to build your first listing source of motivated seller listings. Do you have a real estate success plan for when real estate goes into another recession? And it will. Do you have a plan for the next 5 to 10 years? In listing generation system, I compress time. Everything that I learned while I was working for brilliant real estate investors. I show you how they set themselves up to have a solid business. They would thrive during good or bad economic times. So, you know, here's your real estate business. Your first business is your chapter 13 listings. The next one could be another source. The next one could be referrals, probate, divorces. And I show you how to build several others. Your first source will be chapter 13s. There's nothing complicated about them. It's very easy. The sellers are motivated. We do not negotiate everything. The properties are sold as is. Do you want to have a strong connection with your clients? When you help a client that is in chapter 13, someone that is going through tough financial times, they think they're going to lose everything, and you hand them a check for $75,000 or $100,000 or even $35,000, they will love you. They will turn into raving fans and refer you, and they will pay you what you are worth. Sign up today. They're going to start soon. 6 modules of live webinars. It's one payment of $9.95. If you do this, you get the listing flyers, the brochures that convert listing prospects into listings and closed escrows. This took me years of work, tens of thousands of dollars I spent on creating them, printing them, and in postage, testing them. They are very effective. Or you can do 4 payments of $297. Private coaching 101 is also available. If you have any questions, I will make myself available to you. My cell number is 213-804-7437. Or go to listinggenerationsystem.com-webinar. Here, let me make this bigger. Not that big. There you go. My staff is familiar with this type of marketing. They will be available to you if you want to use them to create flyers, brochures, and websites, since all this is non-conventional thinking. This is the end. Have a nice rest of your day, and thank you for attending the webinar. Oh, this is how the page looks. If you sign up.